Good morning, Nick. I hope you have slept well. What a busy day yesterday, huh? The cargo transfer is completed, and the cargo surveyors have started checking the cargo tanks and calculating the quality. The cargo hoses are now being disconnected from the Mary's manifolds. They are drained, blanked off, and lifted on board the Rio, as they are going to attend one more STS operation after this one. As soon as the crew is available, the fenders should be shifted from the Mary to the Rio. We will go to the deck and assist the crew, demonstrating how this should be done. This will be a good opportunity for you to pick up valuable knowledge. But first, we have a meeting with the master and the chief officer of the Mary at 6 o'clock to check that everything is ready for unmooring. And then we can fill in and get a confirmation of STS checklist number 5, just before we commence with the operation at 6:30. So, now let's discuss the unmooring principles. Can you tell me which of the mooring lines you think we should let go of first? Good. The time is almost 5:30 a.m. now. So let's go to the bridge and meet with the master and the duty navigational officer. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, let's go through the unmooring plans. As you know, the Rio awaits another cargo transfer here in Transfer Bay, and therefore Michael, the master at the Rio, suggested we do the unmooring at anchor. As you know, unmooring with one ship at anchor can be complicated for several reasons. For instance, the wind can be unfavourable in combination with tide. Tidal current can cause problems. Hydrodynamic interaction can occur between the two ships. And local conditions and ship configurations can complicate things as well. Generally, you should never use this method during change of tide. We have very low winds and stream here at the moment. My concern is to get enough energy in between the ships to create a separating force. I think there is a risk of us colliding. Therefore, I will go for unmooring with both ships underway. If we follow the normal procedure, we will be starting with the wind and sea on the port side. Then we bring the combined two-ship system to headwind in order to get energy in between the ships to spread them apart. After disengaging, it is essential that neither of the vessels attempt to steam ahead or fall astern of the other until both ships are well separated. As soon as we are clear, let's say at a distance of approximately 300 meters, we inform the Rio that we are clear and both vessels can navigate independently. Okay? Good. As soon as we are finished here, I will inform the Rio about the intended maneuvers. Regarding the unmooring, the forward gang should start by letting go of the forward springs and then the bow lines. Next, the after gang will let go of the stern lines and finally the after springs. David, will you take a copy of this unmooring plan and give the information to the second and third officer?
Yes, no problem. We know this procedure.
Very good. Then I will contact Michael on the Rio to inform him and his crew about the unmooring plans. See you all here again soon. Okay, we are almost ready for the unmooring now. I have agreed with the master of the Rio to commence the unmooring at 6:30. Before I give the start signal, I want to be sure that sufficient personnel is allocated to the mooring stations and that they have all been given a thorough explanation of the unmooring procedures. Can you confirm this, David?
Yes, Peter. We have also trained them in the toggle pin technique as you required. And I've just checked the communication with the mooring gangs.
Good. And all the necessary equipment has been checked and is at hand?
Sure, and the cargo transfer side is cleared.
And what about shipping traffic?
It has been checked, and there are no potential problems.
Okay, then I will complete STS checklist number 5 and get it confirmed before I give signal to commence unmooring. Hi, Michael. Superintendent Peter Jansen here. We have the right speed now and the wind in on port bow. Are you ready for unmooring?
Hi, Peter. Yes, all men are on their posts and ready for action.
As you can see, we follow the most common method of unmooring. As the manoeuvring ship, we now have to move clear of the Rio. It's very important to adopt utmost care during letting go of the last lines. That's why I have ordered use of the toggle pins. First, they heave in on the messenger and then remove the mooring lines from the bits. When they slack the messenger line, the toggle will release itself and the messenger will be freed, so the mooring line can slide through the fair lead over the side. With this method, two lines can be released at the same time. When the last mooring is gone, we will turn the vessel slowly to port to have the wind dead ahead in order to split the vessels. Now we are free of the Rio, but it's still essential to coordinate the manoeuvres, and the speed should not exceed 6 knots before we are at a safe distance. Congratulations! You have now completed your first STS transfer operation without failing. But we still have some time before we can sign off, so I'll suggest we make a thorough evaluation of the complete operation.